hair review for Youth Beauty Hair. Now y'all just about to see how I customized it and how I put it on my head, flat iron it, and do all that great stuff. You about to see that right now. Okay, so the packaging for Youth Beauty looks like this. It's real fancy. I think it's real nice. I like that it's not basic, you know, how everybody else just get a box or something. You get a bag and you can hang this wig up, and in the inside you can clip it up, and also you get a weaving cap and elastiband and wig clips as well that comes inside, and then you know your wig comes inside too. And after you take this off, you can literally just sit the wig back up in this bag and sit it in your closet. That's how fancy this is. Now look at the back. Like, this is real fancy. I feel like the packaging goes well with the price. The shipping is 10 out of 10 too. It was supposed to get here on Friday. It got ordered on Monday. It was supposed to get here on Friday, but it ended up coming Wednesday. So it came 2 days early, which is really good too. And the reason I said the packaging goes with the price, because this wig is a little bit more on the pricier side. So I'm glad that the packaging kind of corresponds with the price. And you're like, that's crazy, da da da. But the price is for this wig right now is $295.20. That's pricey. I know that's not really in everybody budget, but if you have the budget to splurge, I don't think it's a bad wig at all. And we're gonna get into these pros, into these cons after these specs, honey. So I got a lace front wig, just a regular basic lace front wig, and it's 150 density, 20 inches, and it's the 613 color, and it's platinum blonde. It's really white, like, but I like it. It's the perfect wig to dye a different color. But the first pro is it curls. You are able to curl it. It doesn't hold a curl for a long time, but the curls doesn't drop right away either. The second one is you can get this hair bone straight. As you can see, this hair is really bone straight. Like, girl, it's bomb. Like, I ain't never think I could flat iron hair this good. And I usually flat iron my hair off a mannequin head. And that's what I did. Instead of it being on my head. And I got this hair really bone straight, y'all. Like, look at this. It's straight, honey. She's straight and she's hair. Next one is that it flows really well. Like, you can see it's not stiff. It's not none of that. Like, you can move it, you know. Flows, it's not stiff at all. The next thing is it's not fried. You know how you think blonde hair comes fried? Well, that's personally me. I'm just like, how did you get this color? Yeah, the ends of it is not bad at all. Now, I flat iron this hair like crazy all the time because I don't know how to flat iron hair, but the ends of this hair is not that bad in my opinion. For it to be blonde hair, it's not that bad. The ends are not fried. It doesn't like feel crispy or anything at the ends or rough. You get what I'm saying? Like, I don't know if that makes sense, but you know how hair can be soft and then when you get to the ends, it's just like, yeah, it doesn't feel like that. Oh, this hair is super soft. You could play in this hair all day if you really wanted to. Like, you could literally just run your fingers through this hair nonstop. I mean, I could do it in a whole video and y'all would be annoyed right now. I'm just saying. You could run your fingers through this hair. Now, this is the perfect blonde to dye a different color. So say if you want like a pastel pink or anything, whatever color you wanted, this color right here is the perfect color for you to be able to achieve that. So I do like that is this really light blonde, because then you'll be able to achieve any color that you want without having to worry about if the color payoff is going to be different. No, this is like literally platinum white blonde, so you'll be able to dye it any color that you want. It's true to length. Of course, it's 20 inches. It is what it says. It's bomb. I like it, as y'all can see. It kind of grew on me. I've been wearing it out in public, so I'm pretty comfortable with wearing it outside. I never thought I would be, but I am. Some cons for this hair. We got about 4. The first one is this hair sheds. Now, it has died down on a shedding since it was shedding yesterday, but I did cut the lace, cut the ear tabs, so I don't know if it was from that, but it was shedding. Today it's not shedding as much as it was shedding yesterday, so maybe it just had to get the hairs that I cut for my ear tab right here out. I don't know, but it was shedding, not like a huge amount, but it was shedding, you know. And I'm thinking maybe because it's blonde hair it sheds, so I could be wrong, but it was shedding a little bit more than your black hair or like curly hair. Even curly hair doesn't shed a lot, but it was shedding, okay? And I don't know if that's just because it's blonde or what. It was shedding though. Next thing, you can see the cap for this wig. Like, I'm gonna insert a clip right now. You can see the cap, like, you can see the tracks in this wig, like, so I don't know. It's 150 density, so I don't really know why you can see the cap, but you can see the wefts right in this area, as y'all just saw. The next thing is it looks a little wiggy, and that's coming from a person that wear wigs a lot. But it is 613, so I'm thinking maybe because it's blonde it looks wiggier, if that makes sense. So, but it's not like a bad wiggy, it's an okay wiggy look. Y'all will let me know if it looks wiggy, but I can say that it does look a little wiggy. Y'all can see the edges. It was kind of hard to do them because this is my first time working with blondes, so I was just like, But the next and last final con is flyaways. Oh my gosh, it's a lot of flyaways with this wig. And I don't know if that's just because it's blonde hair again. I don't know if I'm only experiencing this because it is blonde hair. But it's a lot of flyaways. Like, I had to use a slick stick, one of these right here that I got for the beauty supply store, because it's a lot of flyaways with this wig. I'm sorry. I don't know why so many. It's a lot. Especially at the top. It's a lot. And it still looks nice. You can't take away from the fact that it doesn't look bomb. The hair quality is not horrible at all. It flows, it moves, it just has flyaways and minor things that need to get fixed for it to be better. But it's not worse. Like, if you're looking for some blonde hair, I don't think this is some bad blonde hair. I just think that it has minor things that you might have to deal with. Like I just told y'all in a video, that you gotta deal with. Hey, it is what it is. Sometimes we gotta deal with things. Especially if you're not trying to pay a whole lot of money. I know $295.20 is a lot of money, but it's blonde hair. You get the wig already made and everything. So the links to this hair will be in the description box down below. If you want to check this hair out, the links is down there for you to check it out. Any information about this hair will be in the description box. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below and I'll answer them. And hopefully y'all enjoyed this video. If y'all did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up if you want. And don't forget to subscribe down below if you want as well. And yeah, bye y'all.